As a submission for code for her, we have chosen the second problem, that is, we have designed an interactive forum for members and supporters. This is a real-time web-based chat application which has space that users can join according to their interests. We have made this using Node.js and use modules and IO libraries like socket.io, Express, and NodeMon. Over to you, Sonia.
This is a user interface where user enter in their desired event. They just have to enter their name and join the space. Achal, please open the chat.html. This is after joining the space. It is a real-time application. It will let the user know if the participant has entered and keep them updated about each participant. On your left, you can see it is a source code of this particular chat space. Here you can see we have included CSS file, style sheets, and JS files. There you can see we have included some of the icons that you can see on our user interface page. Achal, please open CSS file. CSS is where we modify our user interface page. This is a color palette, the color that we have included in our website. We have kept in mind the Aspire for Her site, which has really beautiful shades of pink and green. We have included many classes here, but I'll highlight some of the unique features of CSS file. The pretty background that you can see is made using linear gradient with the pastel shades of green and blue. Apart from this, we have included some of the features, like we have kept overflow auto so that user list and messages don't move out of the chat space. We have provided styling to the button, the font style that we can see in the box styling and a box shadow so that the color pop out really beautiful. By tapping leave space button, you will leave the space and other user will be notified. Over to you, Achal.
Since I have done the backend part with my co-member Rishika, so we'll be explaining all the stuff together. In this app, we will be using package.json file to maintain the module's version. This is our file. This file can be created with the help of the command npm init in the terminal section. Later on, we have installed some of the dependencies like Express, Movement, Socket.io, and NodeMon. Express is a robust set of features for web and mobile application, and NodeMon is a utility that will monitor for any changes in our source and automatically restart our server. And from this only, we are able to restart our server again and again automatically.
Since this is a real-time chat application that allows you to send and receive the message without any refresh, we have used Express, NodeMon, Socket.io, etc. These are some constant declarations where we have defined the paths, endpoints, ports, etc. The functions that were installed are used using require function. Here we have included the comments, so you can go through these and understand them by line by line. And a chatbot, here's a chatbot which will let you know when the user joins or leaves the chat. Achal, please take it down, scroll it down. Port to the port. Yeah. So port is a communication endpoint. By default, we have used localhost port number 3000.
So this is user.js. This is all about the user information. Like whenever the user leave the group, how will other members get to know about which user had leave the group? So here, with the help of the ID, other users will get to know which particular member has left the group, and they will get to know. So this is all about that. Whenever the user enters the particular space or leaves the particular space, or
message a particular space, so other users will get to know by their ID. So here we have included a unique library that I would like to highlight, movement. So movement, the time that you see after a message, that when the message was sent or received, so this is done by using this library movement. Since we are sitting at remote location, so there are some changes that we had to do in this HTML file. So this was the walkthrough to our project. Hope you liked it. Check the description to see our source code. And here is a glimpse of a working site.